There's one thing I regret with this computer, and that is... This is my 14-inch MacBook Pro in the base model configuration. That means no extras, no nothing. So this is the cheapest 14-inch MacBook Pro you can buy right now. And calling this cheap is really weird because it's still 2 grand we're talking about. When you spend this amount of money on a computer, you're really looking for one thing, and that is workflow improvement. So let's talk about power first, because I feel like when people hear the term base model, most of them are afraid that this thing is not gonna have enough power. But with this, that's really not the thing, because this is super powerful. As a quick information, I use the Adobe Creative Cloud, which means I use Premiere Pro, Lightroom, and Photoshop on a daily basis. And I know that the Adobe programs aren't really that well optimized for the M1 line chips. So if you're using other programs that are better optimized, the results may look very different. So just as a heads up. And I know you really don't want to see me just sitting here talking about it. So let's jump into Premiere Pro, and I'm actually going to show you how the editing process looks with this. I know this looks super ugly, but we're just going to have to live with this now. Okay, so I have a 4K sequence over here. Playback, full resolution, and a random clip from my last video shot on my Sony a7 III at 60 megabits, 25 frames a second. As you can see, scrubbing is super smooth. Playback, also smooth. And really, this thing handles this kind of footage super well. Okay, so let's move on to this same clip, but 5 times. And as you can see, scrubbing is also super smooth. Playback, also smooth. Yeah, that's just me sitting still. Okay, so really, as you can see, this thing handles this kind of footage super well, even 5 times. And really, no one's gonna do this, really no one. And I know this isn't really the hardest codecs, but if you're gonna use like a really hard codecs, like 8K footage, you're probably not even gonna look into the base model of this. So for most of us, this thing is gonna eat everything we're gonna throw at it. Really everything. Okay, so I think we now know that this is more than enough for editing in Premiere Pro. And this has really changed my editing workflow, and it just improved it by 100-fold. The export times are also great, but it's not as impressive as the in-timeline experience. And this is probably where the higher spec versions of this are gonna be better and are gonna have faster export times. But let me ask you one question. Would you rather edit on a computer that has super fast export times, but the in-timeline editing experience is super slow and really not that pleasant? Or would you edit on a computer that has slow export times, but the in-timeline experience is super smooth and really stress-free? I think most of us would really pick the latter. Just think about what actually saves you the most amount of time and nerves. For me, it really comes down to the editing experience, because when I hit export, I usually just stand up, take a break, grab something to eat, take a drink, and do whatever, and just come back, and then the export is finished. So it doesn't matter if it's 15 minutes or 20 minutes. At that point, buying the higher spec versions are gonna save you like a few minutes. Of course, if you go for the M1 Max, but that's a whole nother story. But just think about it. Are these 5 minutes or 10 minutes really worth that amount of money? And I really don't think so. And I know some of you are gonna be interested in real export times from this machine. So I'm gonna put the export time for this video in the description down below. And while you're down there, just hit that like button. I would really appreciate it. And also consider subscribing. That would really help me out a lot. Okay, so let's move on to how this really affects my photography workflow. So my photography workflow looks something like this. I come home from shooting the photos. I plug in my SD card, dump them all in a folder on my computer. Then I look through this folder and add tags to whatever photo I like. After that, I'm gonna do a second revision and look for these photos I tagged, and then decide which ones actually get edited. Doing this on my old computer was really a hassle because the load time between pictures was actually really long. And I'm even shooting my RAWs and compressed, so that really even didn't help. So I actually timed how long the whole editing process of a 1,600 photo shoot took me. It ended up at 6 hours. And of these 6 hours, I did the math, and It turned out I looked at the loading screen for 1.5 hours, which is just crazy to think about. And I know benchmarks are really boring, but the SSD speed on this thing is just crazy. And it really cut down my editing process by 100-fold. Not really 100-fold, because if you do the math, it's gonna be probably less, but it really, really saves me a lot of time, and the load times are way, way shorter on this than on my old computer. And that is what really matters. This thing is saving me time. This thing is also more than performance, really. The performance packs a punch, but the body does too. And I know we all know that the Apple products have like great bodies, and it's just the build quality is amazing. I really want to give my opinion on this too, because that is actually also something that really helped me out. Okay, so I'll make this relatively short. The screen is amazing. The contrast ratio is just crazy. Mini LED technology works really great. 120 Hz ProMotion is also amazing. Does the notch bother me? No. I got used to it pretty quickly, and the extra screen real estate is really worth it. So the notch really doesn't bother me at all. The speakers are out of this world. I don't know what witchcraft this is, but these speakers are unworldly amazing. I've actually opted to using the speakers a lot more, and I'm actually ditching my AirPods like over and over again, because when I don't bother someone around, I actually use the speakers from this because they're just that amazing. The keyboard on this is amazing. The Touch ID, I absolutely love it. I think that's probably one of my favorite features on this. Also saves you time. Login is super quick. I know it's not really something that this computer has and other computers don't, but I really love it. So the trackpad is amazing. I don't know what kind of dark magic they pulled into this, but I love it, and it was absolutely worth it. I've had an old MacBook, and I already love the trackpad on this thing, but the newer trackpads on these Macs are just, I love them. It's super smooth and really the best trackpad out there. Okay, so all that being said, there's one thing I regret with this computer, and that is not buying it sooner. I know it sounds really cheesy, but this computer is absolutely amazing. I know it's $2,000, but the value you're getting from this is super amazing. I think this is probably the best laptop you can buy right now. If you're contemplating between this and a 13-inch MacBook Pro with a more higher spec, I would really recommend you to get this, because this is really worth its money, and like the extras you get with this are just amazing, and it's really worth the extra dollars. If you're one of those people contemplating to put in some extras into this thing, I would recommend you not to do it, because this has more than enough power. Okay, so if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button. I would really appreciate it. Also consider subscribing, that would really help me out a lot. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to watch this video as well, because it might really interest you. Okay, so I will see you in the next video.